Well, as a life member of the Stafford Volunteer Fire Department in Western New York, I want to applaud all of you for what you do each and every day. In my private life, I'm in the insurance business, and I can tell you that you are not only my best friend, but the best friend of insurance companies for what you do. And I can remember one day, about 2 years ago, I was in church, and I got an alert that there was a fire with a 40-mile-an-hour wind in February coming out of the west. And unfortunately, the house was built in 1820, and the owner had just put a metal roof on the west end, on the east end, and it was coming out of the west, and they couldn't get underneath that metal roof to save the house, so it became a total loss. But in most cases, what you do each and every day saves not only property, but saves lives. So thank you for what you do. I applaud both Senator Seward and Assemblyman Tagg for this legislation. With this week dedicated to EMS Week in New York and Memorial Day this coming weekend, it brings into perspective groups of extraordinary people that deserve credit each and every day of the year, veterans and our first responders. These brave groups of men and women sacrifice for their country, for their state, and for our communities. I've introduced legislation to award active duty service members an income tax credit. And my colleague, Assemblyman Tagg, as I mentioned, has now introduced legislation to do the same for you, our first responders. We're here today because the fact is that firefighters and EMS departments are struggling throughout the state of New York. Whether it's Western New York, the North Country, the Southern Tier, or anywhere else, volunteerism is very, very difficult. The cost of this legislation is minimal, and I applaud Assemblyman Tagg for introducing it. And I'm convinced that if a state who has a $176 billion budget annually can support our dedicated volunteers, this will help, as has been mentioned, eventually to attract and retain citizens who serve in our communities as volunteer firefighters and EMTs. Our EMS and police will be out in full force this weekend, working around the clock to protect the public from impaired driving and rushing to accident scenes that are associated with Memorial Day. Dedicated and brave volunteers are the heartbeat of these organizations. Many times, sacrificing, as has been mentioned, family obligations and other interests to be on call and to keep our communities safe. They are on the front lines of not only dangerous fires, but situations involving crime, drug overdoses, and other perilous activities. What better way and what better time than EMS Week and National Police Week, just last week, to show our gratitude to our first responders? I implore my colleagues across the aisle and assembly leadership to join us in saving volunteer fire departments and emergency service centers by passing this legislation before the end of this session. Thank you.